Planet Dolan.
What secrets are you hiding from yourself? And which of those are still a medical mystery too? Here's the top 15 unsolved mysteries about our own bodies. I'm Melissa, and today I'll be your narrator. Number 15. Appendix. The appendix is often described as a vestigial organ, something that has stuck around from our evolutionary ancestors, even though we no longer need it. Your tailbone, at the bottom of your back, is similar. It used to connect the tail to the body, but now it's useless. However, recently scientists think they have come a step closer to finding out its purpose. Dr. Heather Smith found that an appendix had evolved independently in over 30 species and seems to help replace some bacteria in the intestines, if you lost it through diarrhea, for example. We're still very vague on the details, though. Number 14. Aging. No matter how many creams and treatments you buy, aging is only ever a one-way street. But what exactly is the cause of this wrinkling of the skin and weakening of the muscles and joints? Are we programmed like this to free up food sources and living space for the next generation? Or is it that our DNA just gets damaged over time so parts can't be repaired? The DNA damage looks like it can be reduced if you eat only the exact calories that you need. So, it's certainly a factor, but how everything combines to create aging is unknown. Number 13. Weakest apes. When you compare humans to our fellow apes, and even our ancient ancestors, we may come out on top when it comes to making iPhones and doing the crossword, but put us in a ring together and we would get our asses handed to us. The weakness of modern humans is down to our more sedentary lifestyle. We have no need to be particularly strong thanks to tools and domesticating animals. But we don't know why it was in our benefit to lose strength over a long period of evolution. Number 12. Gut bacteria. Around 1% of your body mass is made up of the various bacteria passengers you carry around all day. Some of them are helpful, some are harmful, and others are just up to their own mysterious business. It's in your gut where they play a really major role, helping you break down certain food types as well as absorbing elements like carbon and nitrogen. However, there are thousands of different types, so there's a whole ecosystem going on in your intestines, one we've only just started to uncover. Number 11. Dominant hand. About 90% of people are right-handed, and this is super weird when you think about it. Firstly, what is the use of having a dominant hand at all? Perhaps it's our brain's way of helping us train. If you kept doing a fiddly task, like writing, with a different hand, it might take you longer to learn it. But even if we solve that mystery, that still leaves us with a right-handed issue. It's not like nature is better suited to rightness. There's no right-handed trees or fruit, so why did we pick sides? Number 10. Sleep. It seems like sleep must be a natural part of all life. You do stuff, you get tired, it's just the way things work. But sleep is very different across species. Bacteria are too simple to sleep exactly, but they do have a kind of rhythm that matches the passing of the day. Even within mammals, there's a big variety. Giraffes only sleep for about 30 minutes a day, often in little power naps of a few minutes, standing up. Dolphins and orcas sleep half a brain at a time, so they don't drown or get attacked. So maybe humans are just genetically lazy with our 8 hours a night. Number 9. Male nipples. When we're developing in the womb, we all start out as basically female for the first few weeks. When men switch and the male genitalia starts to develop, they've already been given nipples. But in most mammals, the hormones seriously limit nipple development, but human men get full sensitive connected nipples that are completely useless. Well, outside of an S&M dungeon, of course. Number 8. Autism. Although the anti-vaccination movement would have you believe that vaccines cause autism, this is completely untrue, and the sad reality is that we're just really still unclear about how this disorder works. We don't know if it's caused by genetics, environmental factors, or something else. To make it even more confusing, we should really talk about autisms rather than autism, since its effects are so varied. Number 7. How do we track time? When people talk about their body clock, they normally relate this to sleep patterns. But you actually have a number of different clocks that monitor hugely different scales of time. You can sense hours passing through the day, a feel for the years gone by, and you measure milliseconds to coordinate your actions like catching a ball or jumping a gap. Most impressive is hearing. If you hear a loud bang, you can tell the direction it came from. This is because the sound wave has to travel slightly further to reach one ear, due to your big fat head in the middle. This difference in time is only millionths of a second, but you measure it and calculate it in an instant, turning towards the sound. But where these clocks are and how they work, that's a complete mystery. Number 6. Pregnant smelling power. Apart from giving you the magic power of being able to squeeze a little human out of you, pregnancy also messes with your senses, specifically, your sense of smell. We used to think that that sense was boosted, and that pregnant women could pick out subtle odors better than when no bun was in the oven. Research has disproven this, but it hasn't found a reason why many expecting mothers notice that they react very differently to smells, often being much more sensitive to them and how they react. Number 5. Yawning. We used to think that yawning was caused when you were tired, so your breathing had slowed down. This meant the level of oxygen in your blood was lower, so the yawn was an attempt to take in a big extra dose. But research has proven this idea to be incorrect. They found yawning was just as frequent if you were oxygenated. We also don't know why it's contagious. It seems to be linked to empathy in some way, since people with autism and psychopaths are much less likely to catch a yawn. Number 4. Blushing. The biology of blushing is pretty simple. You get a sudden dose of adrenaline, and this makes the capillaries widen and carry more blood, making it especially visible near the skin surface. But this kind of fast reaction must be related to your ancient fight or flight response. So, why is it caused by having a sexy teacher ripping off your pants in public? What does our weird little subconscious think is about to happen? Number 3. Hypnic jerk. A hypnic jerk sounds like someone who does crystal healing and sells vegan breast milk. But it's actually that weird thing some people do as they're falling asleep. They suddenly have a spasm, normally jerking their head upright. It feels like you're falling and then suddenly, you snap awake. Why would your brain play this awful practical joke on you? Some people believe it's a hangover from our monkey past to make sure we didn't drop out of the trees while snoozing. But you're actually not falling, so the reasons behind it are still unknown. Number 2. Bright light sneeze. Staring at the sun is very bad for your eyes, but for around 20 to 30% of us, it's also an irritation for our noses as well. Looking up into a bright light, typically the sun, causes many people to sneeze. Achoo! It's not caused by any specific light wavelength. It's only related to the intensity. But that's about the limit of our knowledge on it. Number 1. Memory. We store a huge amount of data in our heads. Names, faces, skills, and for some reason, all the mean things are X-ed to us.
I know Kung Fu.
But where is all of this information going? How is it sorted and how is it accessed? For over a century, we thought the memories were stored in the synapses, the connections between the brain cells. But research in the last few years shows that even this may not be true. So we might know even less than we thought, which wasn't much anyway. One thing we have learned though, is that the reason you forget things when you are drunk is because you don't actually make a memory. It's like you've just turned the camera off. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time.